We'd like to welcome you from wherever in the world you join us today for this F1 qualifying session here in Shanghai, China. Now then, Anthony Davidson, you're not getting any younger, but you have been involved in your fair share of qualifying sessions in an illustrious 30-year career. How do you deal with the pressure when you have that one chance to deliver a perfect lap?
It's not so much about dealing with the pressure, it's more about how you approach the risk and just how much of it are you willing to take. You're constantly balancing the car on the edge of grip from braking, cornering and traction. And over the course of a lap, it's easy to get that balance wrong. And that's why achieving the perfect lap is almost impossible. As you say, I've been doing this 30 years now, and it never gets any easier.
Fantastic. That was the fastest lap. Second place. So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 36.0.
The grid is all set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Vettel, Hamilton and Kimi Raikkonen. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself...
Amazing performance out there. You must be really happy. Are you happy with where you'll be on the grid tomorrow? It's the start of the season. How do you think things are going to go for you? Great! Well, that's everything.
Right, I think we can call that a successful qualifying.
Ever since the Sauber of Felipe Massa passed Jenson Button into Turn 1 at the very first Chinese Grand Prix in 2004, Shanghai has consistently provided close racing and extraordinary memories. It's where Lewis Hamilton effectively lost the title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg claimed Mercedes' first win of the modern era in 2012. We start a lap here at Shanghai with the long, difficult right-handers of turns 1 and 2, the first of 16 corners that make up this 3.3-mile circuit. The incredibly long back straight provides the best passing opportunity of the lap, with speeds in excess of 200 miles per hour before the braking zone of turn 14. Anthony Davidson joins me again for the race today. Let's talk about Baker. As with all the drivers at this level, they have a lot of ambition. But Formula One's a daunting step up from any other series, so expectations are high right from the start.
And this is something that has ended the career of many a young driver, as that leap up to Formula One proves to be too much. But luckily, in this case, I'd say they're doing a good, solid job, and the risk the team took in signing them is definitely starting to pay off.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Baker, Max Verstappen, and Bottas, Ricciardo, Hülkenberg, Sainz, and Sergio Perez, Grosjean, Alonso, Esteban Ocon, and Magnussen, Hartley, Leclerc, Lance Stroll, and Stoffel.
Okay, we qualified higher than we were anticipating. Let's see if we can do just as well in the race. Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. Good for now. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights.
Pit now.
pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Is 5.2 seconds. Our gap behind is 2.7 seconds. 17.5 seconds. Seconds.
Fuel remaining.
Charles is out of the race. This is your final lap.
5. We did it. Good job.
A great win then for the Sauber team today. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres, but at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else, and that's exactly what they had today.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. It's a good result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'll probably go for Pierre Gasly. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in amongst the pack, but it's the driver's job to capitalise on those opportunities, and he did so with a lot of skill.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.